Good evening and welcome to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove. We hope that everyone is well. We hope that the weather in Brighton is treating everyone well. Yes. Currently, we're a little bit...
Delirious,
but, you know, we would never say no to hot weather. Debs, how are you doing?
I'm very, very well, thank you. Very excited about today's show. And to kick off in fine style, I would like to say a big hello to our first guest, Rick Morris, Simonian Brighton Tours. Hello, Rick.
Hello.
How you doing?
Yes, good, how are you?
Warm.
Yes. It is warm. Warm weather, perfect time to go on a walking tour.
It's great. It's great to be outside and discovering the city.
I'm just going to launch in there. What your tours, they are stuff of legends. They've had amazing write-ups, reviews, the whole nine yards. Tell us about them.
Okay.
Tell us about them.
I want to know about these tours. Tell me about them.
So, the main tour I do is called Only in Brighton!
Nice.
Which is a fun, tongue-in-cheek look at what makes Brighton unique and a bit weird.
That's what we do.
Yay!
But you do it walking around Brighton.
I do it walking around in the sunshine.
Oh, fantastic, fantastic. So how did this tour come about? I mean, it's a fantastic idea because, let's face it, Brighton is... I hate the word quirky, but I'm going to say it. Brighton is a quirky place. It's got lots of different parts to it. It's quite unique. And the sense I'm getting is you take people around on this tour and you show them that uniqueness.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I'm a qualified blue badge tourist guide. So I do tours anyway.
Yeah.
And then I moved to Brighton, 12 years ago? Okay. And I was in the pizza place next to the Jubilee Library. And I just suddenly had an epiphany. And I just wrote down, 12 things that make Brighton unique, and a tour kind of appeared there.
Wow.
I've been doing it since 2011 in the Brighton Fringe and most weekends.
Amazing.
You see, that is the magical power of pizza, isn't it?
Yes.
You just sit down and all this magic happens.
It was a Romano, if you wanted to know.
Okay.
Very thin crust.
Very nice.
So what was on the initial list?
Yeah.
And has it changed?
Can you tell us?
A few things, yes. Some things have come and gone. Twacker used to be on it, but I couldn't quite sort of fit it in with the geography. You know, the drink.
She's kept them in business for some time, but
right.
Sort of. But let me ask you this about Twacker, right? Because they say it's from Brighton, but that's not true, is it?
No, it's from Italy, from Tuscany.
Well, there you go.
And then I think via Colorado, the ski scene. And then initially Brighton was the first place in Britain to regularly stock it. So it became a kind of Brighton thing. But now I think they've been taken over by a large company. Mm-hmm. So it's appearing
Brighton.
Other places. So that's why it's not in the tour. So basically the rest of the world is getting more like Brighton, which is a bit annoying.
You know, yeah. It is. So are you keeping Sturm on the other places? I sense that there's not a lot that you're going to tell us about the locations.
I don't know if you want to keep it. So I talk about things like Prince King George IV, who has been called the worst king in British history.
Oh, wow.
Slightly unfair because he didn't kill people, but Henry VIII did, but never mind.
You know.
So, things like in 1 year, George spent the modern equivalent of £4 million just on his clothes. So it's time for economic crisis. That's not good PR. Yeah.
No.
Yeah. I think we've got quite a few leaders like that at the moment, but
I think most of them are like that.
And then the dodgy building material, like the old building material, the bungaroo.
Bungaroo.
Yes.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Yeah. If your house is damp or you know, it's all a bit falling down, it has been called the worst building material in the world.
Oh dear. Mm. So you've got a whole host of things.
The worst king and the worst building material. There are other good things as well. ABBA winning the Eurovision contest
at the Brighton Dome.
They came here unknown, and from here they became one of the most successful recording artists ever.
Ever.
And it started right here.
And rightly so too, in my opinion.
Yeah, and then the Body Shop as well.
Yes. So Newton Roddick.
Oh, yes, yeah.
So it's a real celebration of things that have come from Brighton and gone on to be, you know, world famous.
Do we get enough credit for this as Brightonians? Because there's so many coffee shop chains now that start as small little independents.
Oh, yeah.
And then someone sees it and they're like, oh, I like the look of this.
That's true.
So I think we need to hype up Brighton as being the... We don't take enough credit for it, do we?
A cauldron or a nursery for things that are cool, perhaps.
Fermenting?
Absolutely.
Probably fermenting as well. Yeah. Something's fermenting.
They're always fermenting. It's the Tuaca. No.
Sorry.
So... How long is the tour? So it's a walking tour. How long is it?
Yeah, so it's about an hour and 20, hour and a half.
Yeah. So that's a good period of time to really get into the subject matter and really enjoy all of those bits. Mm. So it's a daft question, but you're sort of taking people and showing them landmarks and explaining a bit about what that landmark is and what it represents.
Yeah, and it's kind of quite fast and fun, and it's mainly the interesting anecdotes and fun facts, really. Mm. So the kind of things you didn't know about Brighton. So it works out. I've had people that have lived here all their lives and have found out things they didn't know.
Yeah.
But also people, it's their first time in Brighton, they've come from Canada or whatever, and it really gives them an insight into what makes the town tick.
I love it. I love that idea. I'm one of those Brightonians, and I
rare breed.
I will.
A rare breed. As well as doing Only in Brighton, you do other tours as well?
I do, lots of things. I do Peers and Queers,
LGBT
history of Brighton.
Oh,
and it's so there's lots and lots of things on that tour, lots of anecdotes about people that have passed through Brighton or made Brighton their home. There's old gay bars, there's lots and lots of things there. So that's a little bit more serious, a bit more history.
Yeah.
Yes, political protest, all kinds. Mm. Of the first civil partnerships in an English registry office took place in Brighton Town Hall.
Yeah.
So lots of unique things in Brighton there as well.
Fantastic. Excellent. And have you got any other bits and bobs going on as well?
I'm learning to be a London guide now.
As well.
Yes. So,
but can you say whereabouts in London?
All of London.
That's a big undertaking.
All London.
London.
From the Romans until next year.
Brilliant.
Wow. Tours of the future.
Well, I'm doing my exam next year, so I've got to know everything up till then.
Amazing. Yes.
And when you go and hang out with your mates, either in the pub or like if you're in a dinner party, do you have a blue badge identity thing? Like, are you like, oh, sorry, this is just my blue badge. I just.
Not really. I can jump queues with it, but it can't be misused.
You value your popularity too much to abuse your blue badge. Can't say that we do the same. So your target audience, I mean, to me, it sounds like people from walks of life. Sorry, pardon the pun. But it does, I mean, so you, native Brightonians might learn something they didn't already know on the Only in Brighton tour. People, as you said, who've come from Canada and far and wide. Yeah. It's capturing a lot of people.
So there's stuff that you probably didn't know, but it's also sort of getting to the real spirit of what Brighton tick, really. So during the May Fringe, it's mainly Brighton people, and then the rest of the year, it's kind of visitors from other parts of the UK or from around the world.
Wow.
Yeah. And how do people find out about it? Do people need to book tickets ahead of time?
They do need to book tickets, yes. So my website is onlyinbrighton.co.uk the information is there and you can book there. So most weekends when I'm not doing other things.
But is it flexible? Do you fit it in with...
I do private tours as well. So if you've got a group of people, you've got a bit of a party, you've got a celebration, you can book it as a private thing anytime you like. Yeah.
That could also, as well as being for kind of groups of friends, that could be a good... If you want to have a way day, something like that would be really interesting because you're kind of learning and bonding together.
Yeah.
Well, we will, of course, share all of the details of Only in Brighton on our Facebook page, on our Twitter, and all the rest of it, so people can make contact if they want to come along as an individual, or if they want to bring a group, have a private tour. What's next? London is it?
London
what makes you
next.
Want to do that?
I don't know anymore. It's a huge amount of work. It's fascinating. You're dealing with kind of national, international themes. Ooh. Yeah. Yeah.
So what's your funnest Brighton fact?
Oh, lots. Well, there we have the world's deepest hand-dug well in Woodingdean. It doesn't advertise it. It's just outside the Nuffield Hospital at the top of the hill.
We've got some Woodingdean people in the studio who are giving a big up for Woodingdean. Woodingdean massive. So it's
twice the height of the I-360 or dipping
well,
bit underground.
No one talks about that stuff, do you?
That.
Yes, 1860s, I think. So that's the Empire State Building, but down
but
into
down.
The chalk.
And that's still yes. and that's in Woodingdean.
Yes.
And it's not been filled in yet.
No.
It's
the top
cover. We don't talk
about it. We should talk about it. Well, there you go.
So it's an amazing feat of engineering and achievement.
That is really, really amazing. Look, we're coming to the end, unfortunately. Please come back in a few months' time and update us with everything that's going on. Good luck with your London quest. It sounds amazing. And please join us after the break. Thank you.
Hey, welcome back. Great, fantastic second half of the show for you right now, because we have Brighton School of Singing. We have... Hey, Jason.
Hello.
I thought you were Debs or Madeline. When did you change?
I don't know. I took some pills and suddenly I was here.
Brilliant.
Amazing.
This is what happens when
Brighton
you watch.
Brighton School of Singing, Andy. What's going on there?
I was just going to do the ident.
Good.
Yeah,
let's
you know, this is... You're watching PRBH Radio on your TV.
Excellent.
There we go. That was good, wasn't it?
Excellent.
Brighton School of Singing. Who are they? Why am I asking you?
Should we ask them?
Yes. We have... We have Billy and Amy with us. Brighton
Amazing.
School of Singing. What is it? What are you?
So Brighton School of Singing is a community interest company,
yes.
and we're based in Woodingdean. So we offer performance and vocal training to children and adults from the age of 8 and above. And we're a charity, so we rely on like sponsors and funding, and we perform all across Brighton and Hove. We do festivals, we do charity events.
The mayor's
Yeah,
show.
We perform for the Mayor of Brighton every year.
Okay.
And we put on our own gigs every year
as well. So if I were part of another charity or community or something, how would I get you to sing at our event, and would we want you to?
You definitely would want us, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
So you would contact either Gary, who is our musical director and chairman of the club,
okay.
or one of the other members of our board. So both myself and Amy are also on the committee.
Excellent.
So you can contact us about performing and see if we're suitable for what you want. You can come along and watch one of our sessions.
Yeah.
You can send us song suggestions and we'll come along and perform at your event.
Excellent. What kind of songs do you sing?
We do so many things. So we do a cappella, we do pop, we do reggae, we do...
Rap?
Amy's our resident rapper. Mm. Yeah, we do soul. We do a bit of everything. Yeah.
Fantastic.
So, for you, what does it mean to be a part of the school?
Well, my second family.
Excellent.
Everyone is a family, and it always sounds really cheesy when you're like, singing is my family, but everyone is. Everyone gets on so well. And to turn up every Monday and be like, all right, doesn't matter if you've got any problems going on, you're just there with the people that you really care about. You just get to sing and have fun.
That's so great.
That's brilliant.
And you've got your friends coming down, and you're going to do a demonstration for us, aren't you?
We're gonna
Which
perform.
Means we have to kind of bring the show, would you believe, to a bit of a close right now and leave out the rest of the space for these wonderful people to sing to you. What do we need to say?
I don't know, really. What do we need to say?
Okay, after
Stay
this.
Tuned.
we'll cut straight to it. Tune in again next week, where we're going to be back with even more good stuff.
Oh, the top town AC with the coolest system. When I come up in the club and I play's enough. Got stacks on desk like they're saving up. And you, the real, the mic got a deal. They pop up.